3, 2, 1, go!
Partnerships like the one we have with the American Solar Challenge allows us to bring something different to the national park.
The parks get to have these, you know, very unique UFO-looking solar cars show up at their site and really attract attention and be a live demonstration of some of the alternative energy concepts that they're trying to promote.
These are solar-powered cars entirely powered by the sun, built by undergraduate students at universities across the country, as well as some Canadian universities. And they're driving them from here in Northeast Ohio all the way through 9 national parks throughout the Midwest up into Wind Cave in South Dakota.
The purpose of this event is really to provide a multi-discipline, hands-on learning opportunity for these college students. Building a solar car, designing and building a solar car is not something that you're just going to look up the answer in the back of a textbook, so it really forces them to think outside the classroom experience.
I think there's probably 2 goals for this event. The first is for the students to have their competition and to go against each other in terms of their engineering capabilities and to have a fun-spirited competition in that sense. Where the Park Service comes in is to really use this event as a platform to talk about climate change so visitors can learn about not only how climate change is impacting their park, but they can see these young people and these amazing cars that they're building. They can see what the future could look like.
Sustainability matters to this generation because, I mean, we have climate change. Climate change is a real thing, and anything that we can do to help slow it down. And I think it's also very important that we have university students and the younger generation doing this because, I mean, we're gonna be the ones that are really dealing with this, my generation and future generations.
I am very optimistic about the future of clean energy because I think that our generation is filled with a lot of talent and sees the importance of sustainable practices in energy, in transportation, in all factors of human consumption and life.
It's an active way for people to engage in climate change interpretation and activities in a way such that it might not be presented in a textbook. We're allowing visitors to learn about what climate change is and what we can do to reduce our impacts on our environment.
We're able to talk to the public about climate change and how it affects the resources of the National Park Service. And then what we are doing in the National Park Service to plan for the changes that will be occurring due to climate change. Climate change, it all has to do with how much carbon dioxide we are releasing into the atmosphere. So what is our carbon footprint? It's important that the public understands their contribution to that carbon footprint and what they can do as far as reducing their own emissions of carbon into the atmosphere.
We're here today at Wind Cave National Park in South Dakota. Cars have traveled 1,975 miles. It's been an exciting race, and whether students are at the beginning of the race or they're bringing up the rear, we've seen an amazing collaboration across universities.
It went really well. Just now we just crossed the finish line and I don't think I've been this happy in such a long time. It feels so good to see a working car roll through the finish line.
The race was fantastic. It's been an absolutely amazing experience, especially being able to go through all the national parks and having these challenges that are invigorating, are difficult, and really force you to learn. It's not just great for the people involved, it's great for everybody.
It's totally a myth that people aren't concerned about climate change or that they're not ready to act. People are hopeful about clean energy, they're excited about the possibilities, and they're worried about their children's future, and they want to make sure that they can make an impact today to protect tomorrow.